श्रीमती प्रतिमा मंडल जी।
थैंक यू सर फॉर गिविंग मी द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू स्पीक ऑन द डेंटिस्ट अमेंडमेंट बिल 2019। सर हेल्थ इज वेल्थ एंड रिस्पेक्टेड डॉक्टर्स आर द रिसोर्सेज टू मेक अ सोसाइटी वेल्दियर इन टर्म्स ऑफ हेल्थ। There are several acts in the constitution which encompasses this sector. Oral health is equally crucial as any other part of our body, but it is neglected by majority. Better awareness and acts are required to change these notions. The Dentist Bill 1948 came into being from 29th of March 1948. And since then it has been modified several times subsequently. Basically the act provided for two groups of dentists classified under Indian Dentist Register, namely Part A, the ones possessing proper qualification, and Part B, Indian citizen practicing dentistry without technical education at least 5 years prior to the registration date notified. Here it is very important to note that the situation then was completely different. There was a dearth of proper dental institute. There hardly existed any dental institution that would take care of dental health of the mass. This is the major reason for provision under Part D. This is the reason why a lenient approach was opted and persons displaced or repatriated from the neighboring countries as mentioned in the act were given a chance to carry on their means of livelihood. The last registration that took place in Part B was in 1972. At that point of time, representation in the Central Council required a certain sense of equality, and hence the provision ensued to dentists of Part B along with four others from the government side. But today the ratio of Part A, Part B is 2.7 lakh 950. This certainly does not require any form of safeguard. Hence the Dentist Amendment Bill 2019 seeks to remove from the legal framework the representation of dentists who do not have technical education. Also, it is to be noted that the last registration occurred in the year 1972, which denotes that the age of those doctors will be around 70 to 75 years. And being a responsible society, it is our duty to give opportunity to the younger population, since they will lead the country forward. Thus, the subject matter of the bill is justified. But I severely oppose this bill on the ground that the members will be nominated by the government. The essence of democracy lies in empowering its people by giving them the right to choose. By depriving this right in the council, the government is trying to break the pillars of this right. By nominating members in the council, the transparency will be lost. The ruling party will always favor members who are related to them. This should be amended and all the members must be elected. The act provides for a central council which ensures curriculum in institution, registering the pass out of dental colleges, and very importantly secures ethical code of conduct. Thus it is the backbone of the dental health of our country. On this note, I would like to ask the minister through you, sir, whether the government seeks to fix a minimum qualification for the members of the council. This is so because in the present scenario, the members do not have any minimum requirement, whereas the council, being a regulated body, needs experienced and highly qualified members. In the absence of a minimum requirement, the doctors who have not pursued MDS or highly experienced are also allowed to have a say in the syllabus and all other crucial matters. This simply cannot value add in the functions that are to be discharged by the council. Thus we see that the question of whether does not arise, rather it's an urgent requirement to fix our minimum criteria. It is also important for us to provide support to this sector. Out of 310 dental colleges, only 40 are government institutions. A major setback is the uneven distribution of colleges. Certain states like Jharkhand, Northeast states, etc. have very few colleges when compared to other states. Again, as per World Health Organization, the provision of oral health care in rural parts of India is negligible. Various studies have concluded that the unmet treatment need of the population is very high and the services present are inadequate. Record also shows that only 5% of graduates are employed in the government sector, whereas the rest 95% is unemployed in the private field, among which very few afford the expensive latest technology. Private practices, clinics require a heavy investment which is unavailable to the young doctors. Thus, I like to conclude by saying that the proposed amendment is a small step forward which requires a big leap. Our prime focus should be to spread awareness amongst the people, provide better job opportunities, improve the infrastructure of the institution, and most importantly, recruit the truly deserving candidates in the Central Council. Thank you for allowing me, sir, to...
Thank you.